missed it. It's conflict. Quietly preparing. What's going on, guys? If you click that thumbnail, you know where you reached. This is Readings by Marvelous Madame. I am, oh, Marvelous One, Marvelous Madame in the flesh. Welcome back to the show. Burning the midnight oil for you guys tonight to get this good word out to you. Capricorns, where you at, babies? You are up. Finally. Did your video late? I thought I was done. I messed up. But you have since forgiven me. There is a need for quiet preparing. There is a need to want to be happy. There is a need to stay optimistic about your love life. You're ready for love. You're ready for a new beginning. I've been picking up on all of this. You're not going to get a birthday bonus, but I saved you for last because I can take my time and talk to you. It is your birthday season. Happy birthday, Capricorns. I am Capricorn Moon, so this is going to be for Capricorn Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. How the hell are you guys? How is Capricorn season treating you? More importantly, happy day after Christmas. Hope that this video finds you guys well. This is Palo Santo. Well and in good spirits. I am ready to give you this word. I won't see you guys again on video until actually 2019. I'm not recording early. I'm gonna be back with a brand new bag. A brand new bag. Literally, I need a new case bag. But anyway, I'm coming back with a brand new attitude. I'm getting downloads. I'm going through some ascension symptoms. I got a lot going on, obviously, doing this work. You know, I am Cancer Sun, Capricorn Moon. So the full moon in Cancer definitely affected me. And this lunar eclipse in Capricorn will do the same. So if you have my moon, my sun and my moon, you want to hit me up on what I do to try to ground myself and get myself ready, feel free. Readings at MarvelousMadame.com. My phone number and all of that stuff is all over social media. The links below, okay? This is going to be the long-awaited final video for me for 2018 for my last zodiac sign, which is Capricorn. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, once again. We're going to be examining the love energy that surrounds you, Capricorn, right now. We are going to be pulling a Soul Journeys lesson card to close the reading out. Something that you may need to look forward to. Something that you may need to focus on. Something that is going to be representative of your lesson. Something that you may need to close and take into 2019 with you and continue to work on, okay? For those of you guys who are new here with me, hello, hello. For those of you guys who are returning, welcome back. And for my new subscribers, I love you guys. All from the moon and back, thank you so much. I'll get mushy at the end. Let's rock. You know how we do things by now? Romance, angel, oracle cards representing a theme. Back to the back to the back, the bottom, three of those. Then we, who am I? Logic. Take it back, take it way back. Anyway, then we're going to be doing the main energy with Rider-Waite. We're going to be clarifying those energies with Morgan, okay? I did pre-shuffle. If you heard that song I was listening to, that was Hiatus Kayote, Hiatuskayoite. It's called Nakarama. Napalm is the lead singer, dope band. She is very talented, in case you were wondering. It's a beautiful song. Let's go. Oh, I'm not taking that, but some of you guys are connecting with a different type of person. Retreats, Capricorn. New love, Capricorn. And this could be the one. I'm not taking any of those. Some of you guys are dealing with that. We're not going to talk about the birthday bonuses, how I used to do it in the past. I apologize. If I did, I think I did a birthday bonus reading for Scorps, but I kind of rearranged things, and in an effort to get you out of here, I'm not going to do that. I will be reexamining what I want to do as a birthday bonus for the zodiac sign in question. There's an urgency to get out of here, get the message delivered, and kind of get out of here. All of the corniness that goes along with telling you how you are, Capricorn, you already know how you are. I actually like that because I'm into astrology. I'm going to be brainstorming. I do have a lot of changes going on. I will be going live. Whew, Jesus. Let's see. Sorry. And hush. Don't rush me, okay? I will be going live probably Sunday night. Maybe not. Monday night. Right before the ball drops. To say, hey, maybe you guys won't be around. I may do it Sunday, either the 30th or the 31st. Just to go ahead and close us out for the year and say hi to all of the new people and things of that nature, okay? All right. Show me, spirit. Capricorn. What do we got? True love. Okay? This is the romance of a lifetime. What else, spirit? Capricorn. This is the romance of a lifetime. Free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. You've been letting the way that you think control you. I really think that is tied to thoughts, triggers, things that happen in relationships that's emotionally triggering you from really stepping into the true love and accepting it. Which leads to some type of unrequited love, okay? There's not enough attraction or chemistry to keep the relationship going. Not when there is a need to constantly pull up these emotional triggers. Somebody, finances and career, financial issues are affecting you right now. And then chemistry. So, there is a strong magnetic attraction. However, there is a need to get on the same page. All right? There is a need to get on the same page. There is a way in which you and the person you're connecting with does things. Religious factors try to come out. You guys are completely different. But there is a need to get on the same page on how to move forward in your relationship. Show me, spirit. Capricorn, sun, moon, rising, and Venus. Because someone wants to make an offer with this Ten of Pentacles. Someone looks at this relationship as successful. Show me, spirit. This unrequited love. I'm not too concerned about that. Judgment is here. There's going to be a rebirth or awakening as it pertains to this connection. Okay? Show me, spirit. Capricorn, sun, moon, rising, and Venus. The Queen of Cups is going to be here to make an offer. Okay, so we're going to talk about that unrequited love once I get the rest of the cards. Show me, spirit, Capricorn, sun, moon, rising, and Venus. And we got justice. Karmic justice will be served with Libra and energy, yielding that sword of truth and those scales for balance. You better talk about it. So far, you got two major arcana and a five-card spread, Capricorn. Okay. That tried to pop up. You guys are juggling more than one area in your life, but I am not taking it. Of course you are, okay? There's going to be a lunar eclipse on January the 5th, Capricorn. It's going to be bringing a ending, and there's a need for rebuilding something. If the tower comes out, don't let that alarm you. The Emperor, Aries energy. Goddamn. All right. Five cards. Three of those are major arcana. This is your lunar eclipse. There is not enough with this King of Wands. Someone is feeling a little less enthusiastic about things lately. And it could be directly resulting to this. I feel as if someone has been so focused on finances and career that maybe they're operating in a Four of Swords type of energy, more so finances and career, Four of Pentacles type of energy. And if you saw the cards at the beginning that I was showing you, the Four of Swords was there. However, there is a tremendous overpouring of love in this connection. The unrequited love is complete rubbish. This does not mean that you guys are not in love with one another. This has something to do with the way in which you guys are expressing your love based on things that trigger you and things from past relationships. You are being guided to free yourself from what holds you romantically and keeps you from experiencing this true love of a lifetime, as I stated. Okay. Finally, we have Cupid's arrows. The Eight of Wands is in your energy. There is going to be an offer. Again, your top of the month, albeit late, was I am ready for love. If this don't say that you're ready for love, I don't know. This is communication after delays. This is fast communication after the delays. You're going to accept the fact that there is some things that have you a little less enthusiastic right now because of the way that you're focused. You're too focused on what's going on in your career, Capricorn. And I told you a little bit of this in your I Am Ready for Love video. That I don't think you've been too focused on this the way that you're supposed to based on how you are. And that's okay. You're being guided to free yourself from any of this that you felt in the past. These are tied together. This is not current. This is in your history. This is a part of your fiber. This is a part of your being. Let it go. Yes, there was unrequited love in the past. You are to focus on your career and finances to even focus on the fact that the true love is here. You're bringing the same patterns of this unrequited love, and the way that you withdraw makes a person that you're connected with feel less connected. As a result of that, this is what you normally would get in the past. But you have a shitload of chemistry and true love. And I'm not just saying that. I know this is to be correct because this is the damn Ace of Cups. This is what it is, boo. And the Ten of Pentacles. Okay? Let me finish with these cards. Let's pop these zodiac signs off. Gotta put everything back. This is your energy. This is how you view this person. Your energy, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn energy with the Ten of Pentacles, wanting to offer or see stability, a need to build with this person. Not only are they your true love, not only are you in love with the person, you feel like you can build with this person. You trust them on the level of to be able to offer this cup of love. You trust them on the level where they can stand beside you. I wouldn't be surprised if the Empress came out, but we have two totally different energies here with the Emperor and the Queen of Cups. Fire and water, baby. Fire and water. Here we go again. Fire and water. This is Earth. So, let me call it out. Someone's Venus is water. Someone's Venus is fire. That's not good. No. Yes, maybe. Someone that you're connecting with, Capricorn, is either water, Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. This is Capricorn's video. Someone has Aries in their moon or they're rising. But although I never read for Mars, I do see a lot of water signs with a fire moon, but has Capricorn in their Venus or Mars, and it still plays the same way. But more so Mars, because energetically, you feel like if you're not doing this, you're not showing love. If you're not building and you're not achieving, you're not showing love. So that is what you have to free yourself of. Not that that's not what you need to stop doing, but you need to allow a little bit more of emotions to be front and center here. Because I was stuttering for like 5 minutes. Okay, get ugly. Ten of Pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, and Taurus. The judgment is here. A rebirth, the call, the awakening. This is my true love. The Queen of Cups. I am ready now to give you this cup of love. Justice for this unrequited love in the past. Justice will be served. That is how you got to judgment. The past has been healed just by the presence of this person. Libran energy, the sword of truth and the scales. I don't know what this is. I look retarded. The sword of truth and the scales. And we're going to be charging forward with the Emperor. Aries energy coming forth and doing what we need to do. Focused on a stern, solid foundation, authority, structure, wisdom. Not so much as about the hanky-panky, but more so about communicating the love that we were supposed to communicate. Okay? Eight of Wands, Ace of Cups. Okay? Let's clarify. Beautiful, beautiful energy. Beautiful. What did I call it? I am ready to love. I might just call it I'm ready to love part two. Because you are. You're ready. And your energy keeps saying the same thing. The same thing, Caps. This is beautiful. Whoa. You had to dig deep within yourself with this Leo energy. Let go and shed that ego. Dig deep and let those ego patterns go. Free yourself from the unrequited love that you felt in the past. Clear those karmic triggers. Okay? Clear those karmic triggers. This is clarifying your need to build with the person that you're connecting with, Capricorn. Why is judgment here, Spirit? What? Whoa, two cards. Yes. Yes. I'm taking both of them. You realize that this person was worth building with. You needed to start working together with this person and building and realizing that you needed to express the fact that you're willing to take a leap of faith into something stable. I'm not reading three other than trust, love, and whatever that other pinnacle. This is not three people. This is not Jane, Paul, and Sally. No, this is trust. This is love, and this is a leap of faith. That's what we're going to call those three pentacles. That is clarifying the wake-up call, the judgment, the rebirth that was needed to get this situation or get you to a level where you understood. Now, remember, three major arcana. Why is the Queen of Cups here? The Queen of Cups is being clarified by the Lovers, baby. And when I tell you, this is a love, a connection, a deep bond, a spiritual connection, something that defies logic. You don't know what it is, but you are going to take a leap of faith on the fact that this is a love of a lifetime. I might call it love like this. Or a love of a lifetime. I don't know. I don't know yet. Gemini energy. That's beautiful. You came into the realization that this person was for you. You came into the realization without the clarity. Without swords. There's not a sword here. But you came into this realization. We got the Lovers. We got the Queen of Cups. And we got the Ace of Cups, baby. You tell me what it is. Don't have me call this the Ace of Cups, the Lovers, and the Queen of Cups. Because I will call it that. I think I might do that. I don't know what else to say. I'm running out of words for you guys' readings because you're in love. And it's beautiful. You're in love, Capricorn. I'm in love. Joss Stone. Catch me, I'm falling. Clarify justice. Why is justice here, spirit? Whew. Am I taking these? Justice is served. Maybe I'm not. Because you were blocking your emotions in the past. Undecided. Leaving people in limbo with this Two of Swords. Not making a decision. Standing still. That's why justice is served. This. Looking out on the horizon and thinking in your head, passionately thinking, taking the action, taking the time to actually think about this connection, but still not acting on it. What? Physically, passionately thinking and planning the future, but mentally not making the decision. What? Did you hear it? That's what you were doing. Justice brought you out of that. What? Why is the Emperor here? Because you have found your Queen of Pentacles, baby. I'm going to go ahead and clarify it again. The Queen is here. So again, I told you guys that you realize that you can build with the person because of the Ten of Pentacles. You also realize with this Ace of Cups that you can make the offer. But you also, again, to clarify this Ten of Pentacles, this is how you look at the partner that you are dealing with, and this is again clarifying that there's going to be an offer made. There's going to be an offer of love, and there's going to be an offer of stability. Where are we at in time? Was that the Empress? No. This situation moved out of lust at some point, or you figuring out why you could not get enough of a person and really got torn down at some point, and you had to start looking at this situation for what it was worth to you. Okay? Give me one last card for this Emperor and this Queen of Pentacles. You realized that you wanted to make an offer, and you put down, you stopped being the thief. You stopped feeling like you had to operate by yourself, the lone wolf. You stop being deceptive. You stop doing things to get a reaction out of this person. You stopped it and decided rather than to think that you wanted to make an offer, but act like you didn't want to make an offer, that it was time that you put your big boy pants on and get this Emperor energy popping off. And this is what you're going to do because this is where you operate the best, Capricorn. Although this is Aries energy, it's a welcome energy for you because you are the boss, honey. You are the boss. I like to see it. I like to see it. It's in reverse. But you know what? It's in reverse because you don't need, I told you, you don't need swords to know what this person means to you. It's always nice to come, but you don't have to operate from that standpoint where you were defensive and saying shit. Mm-mm. That's what I feel this card represented because this is how you feel. So what do we got? We got two tens, which is the completion. Ten of Cups, you know how I feel about that card. I love it. And then we got the Ace of Cups. What more do I need? I told you guys what I'm going to call it. Now I'm going to call it. Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles, Ace of Cups. That's what the name of this video is. And you don't need the Queen of Swords anymore. You don't need to be blunt and upset. You don't need to operate. This is clarifying energy, by the way. You don't need to operate deceptively. You don't need to operate with and play mind games anymore. I told you. You don't need to operate here. You put these swords down. And that's the reason why the Queen is upside down. All of this energy right here, you no longer need it, baby. You put it down. That's the reason why she is in reverse. Because ultimately, you realize this. And look what's under it. I can't make it up. I can't make it up. Ooh-wee, baby. I'm naming this the Ten of Pentacles, the Ten of Cups, and the Ace of Cups. Call it what you want. It's love. Call it what you want. Let's go ahead and get your closing card again. I told you there was a need for you guys to be happy. How can I love somebody else? You guys were on your Mary J. Blige, baby. You want to be happy. Let's find out how we're going to close this. Spirit, what's the lesson or the blessing for Capricorn to take away? Woo-wee, this is love. I'm loving it. Everybody got good readings for year end. You know, whatever your situation was, it continued to play out. I keep getting that group of people. Woo. Yes, 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 but I'm not taking this. Patience and indecision. Show me, Spirit. Capricorn. Lesson or the blessing. Whoa. Denial and regret. All the things that you need to let go of. Show me, Spirit. Capricorn. Close us out, Spirit. Capricorn. If I get that love card, I'm going to throw these cards across the room. Show me, Spirit. Freedom, baby. I possess the power and the free will to create my own happiness. If you don't want me, then don't talk to me. Go ahead and free yourself. Where is that happiness card? Now I'm going to find it because happiness is the thing. It came out twice. It came out twice. It came out twice. In your pre-shuffle energy, when I was tapping in, we landed on happiness. And where we end is with freedom. Okay? The happiness card is I'm aware that being happy means that I'm on the right path, baby. And also, freedom means is that you possess. And you possess the power and the free will to create your own happiness. And you did it your way. Capricorn. I love you guys so much. Success, baby. That's what this is going to be. I love you guys so much. Thank you for making Marvelous Madame a success. I could not have imagined when I launched this channel in May where I would be. The manifestations that I took into the what I was manifesting was completely meek. Compared to the amount of love that you guys have shown me, I am so unbelievably blessed and happy. Thank you guys so much for all of your support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I hope that this resonated. I want to hear it. I need to hear it. I'm naming this Ten of Cups, Ten of Pentacles, Ace of Cups. That's what I'm naming it. I don't know what else to say. I have run out of words and adjectives to let you know that you are in love. For those that it resonated with. If it resonates, great. If it doesn't, let it skate. I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. I will see you guys in 2019, baby. Back looking like myself. I'm going to go live either on New Year's Eve or the day before New Year's Eve. It will probably be New Year's Eve night before the ball drops. I don't know, but I'll see you back here in 2019. You guys have, hope you had a fantastic Christmas. Happy New Year. I'll see you back here, back looking like myself. And at the top of the month, baby, we are going to examine in the new year, the top of the month in the new year, the love energy that surrounds you, Capricorn. And we're going to find out how Bay feels about you in the middle of your eclipse season. A lunar eclipse. Things are ending, babe. Okay? And hopefully this new love is beginning. I love you. Bye, Cap.